Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the fan server and to this Sunday stream. It has now become a Sunday stream. It used to be a Saturday stream. And also welcome to everybody who's watching on Beam. This is the first one on Beam and potentially one of the last ones I'm doing on Twitch. For those of you who haven't heard, basically, or seen my tweets. Basically, Twitch has announced an associate program, which is like a partnership program, light, you could say. Which is awesome. I've been wanting one of those for ages. But then also... What the heck? Okay. Someone broke in. But then also, the associate's requirements require that you stream exclusively to Twitch. Which is just bullshit. So, they are basically saying, either work for free, or give us exclusive access to your content. So, that's not happening, and I'm kind of regretting that I've been pushing all my links to Twitch for all this time. So, probably not going to do that anymore, if that's the way it's going to be. Anyway, we're on the fan server, and I haven't been on for a while. I know the guys have been hard at work rebuilding the Nether Hub. And I haven't even seen it actually, other than the pictures and like the stuff that they'd built in Creative beforehand and stuff. So why not check it out and do a little bit of a server tour episode? Because I haven't stream. Because I haven't done that for a while. So we'll see how long we keep going today. It's a little bit later start than I would have wanted because I had spent some time resetting up my streaming tools and setting up Beam. And all that, my oh, it seems to have finally have caught up with my little profile picture. I uploaded the little lime thing, and for whatever reason, it wouldn't do it. All right, so let's head on into the Nether, and here we are. This is a new one. The old one was a very very different one. And it appears that there are lots of missing or empty slots here on my side of it. Which is weird, because I thought that there would be more ones here, but okay. We'll go around, we'll find it. Jacktopia Kingdom. It's kind of a nice touch here that we have the banners now, and it's all kind of visible, and we also have the hallways numbered, so you can easily tell somebody where to go. And then we have these little indices, basically. So you can see whose banner is what, which is really nice. I'm waiting for the doors to start clanking. Oh, no. hey, you should accept my server join request. Okay, so let's talk about that. Because we always... Why does this not have any banners? I'm curious. Let's talk about that, because we always end up talking about that. Ooh. So, the server, this server is not strictly whitelisted. So you can see some people are on, but you also see some people have their names listed in italics. And those people are in spectator mode. So you need to be whitelisted to play in survival mode. And in order to get whitelisted, you have to either become a patron, which helps me actually run the server, helps pay for the fees for hosting the server. Or you... is the totem an infinite stack? What? Totem is just a totem. It's survival mode. yes, or you have to sign up to on a list for random draws, and we'll do some at the end of this stream as well. So generally we end our streams with the drawing random names from that list, and we'll give more people access. Oh. Nice. I like those banners. They're nice. Nether Hub storage room. Hello, Sphinxy. Where am I? I'm in the Nether Hub. I'm assuming that the people in the game are now also... are in the stream somewhere. Yeah, exactly. You can teleport around. So this is more the sort of the visuals of the old Nether Hub. It was made out of these materials. Oh, nice. We have jump boost here. I was just going to wonder what the effects were from those. This would be Tucson. Yes, it is. Norwegian flag. Mine creep in Sampedro. I don't have any on-screen stuff set up for Beam yet, but thank you for all of the followings. There's a lot of people following right now. Nice. A lot of tunnels that still need to be finished. So that's interesting, actually. I used to have a pretty long tunnel, and now I'm directly in the hub. That's quite nice. All right, so I don't bother to reset my PIN password. I'm not paying $18.99. What the heck? So, actually, yeah, okay, they'll hold for a bit, but my, yes, I have more. I have absolutely, it said so. I have no idea where you got that number. That's nowhere on any site that I run, for sure. So, yeah, the Patreon thing is $1 at least. Oh, yeah, you've mislinked that. Is that actually a site? Is that like a scam site or something? That's still the wrong link. Alright, this is the spawn area. I was thinking, like, we'll do a little bit of a... Ooh, this is new. We'll do a little bit of a server tour episode. Why do I keep saying episode? Stream. Patreon is almost the same as Patreon. Well, especially since Patreon is actually the word used to describe the people who are your Patreon followers. Even more confusion. But yeah, patreon.com/slime is the correct link. I have no idea what the other one is. We should probably investigate that, because that's a little bit of a sucky thing if that's... if that's like a scam thing. Anyway, this is basically where you spawn in if you're spawning in on the server for the first time. Sort of on the pier here. I don't know exactly where it is because it's been such a long time. Fat, formerly known as Fat Santa Man. So yeah, I'm going to be setting up on-screen notifications down the line, but I just haven't had time. It took it long enough to get this stream going today, so I haven't done it. So hello to all of you over on Beam. I'm recognizing some of the names from other services. I don't think I've seen Reserved Mouse or B-Dog Kempo before. So hi to you guys, and welcome to everybody who's moved over to Beam. And of course, as always, hello to everybody on YouTube and Twitch as well. And like I mentioned before, because now some more people have joined in on Twitch, I'm probably going to be abandoning Twitch at some point. All right, so this is a spawn. People have made like a logo over it. There's stuff over here. This entire castle has been built artificially. There was no island here before. And there's tons of boats and different types of ships and stuff around. So it's pretty cool. We have an electric tower here that I don't think anybody's used since firework flying became a thing. Why am I not using Nightbot? I've been looking at the different bots. We'll see which one I end up setting up. I actually set up one of them once for a little bit, but yeah. There's the whole Enterprise up there. I think it's just a shell. I don't think the... Ooh, this looks broken. Why you do that? So that's a follow notification on Twitch, but it's actually turned off, but it's still apparently playing music or sounds for some reason. coming soon. Catapult. So let's do something like this. Hello? Okay, there we go. Oh, it's so broken. Come on, fly. There we go. This is a little bit of a better... Yeah. Oh, banned. Just go ahead and do slash ban in immediately from now. There's no reason to kick people that just auto join back in and keep spamming. People are idiots. That's just how it is. But this is a pretty big build, this Enterprise. It will be interesting to see if... I don't know if he is intended to actually fill it in. Or can you actually get in? Oh, nice. Oh yeah, here we go. So it's as you can see, it's kind of hollow. But it's a really cool build. Really stunning from the outside. I don't actually know who built the balloons over there either. This is actually a pretty good place to get like an overview. Is he gone? Is it safe? Yep. He's been banned. And somebody, I don't know either who's building out the little section of the island here. Spawn is actually quite a small island, and that's been expanded on quite a lot after the fact. Plus one patron for me. Okay, nice. So if you have your, if you have Discord and you have your Discord connected to your Patreon account, then you, and you join my Discord, you should automatically... by some magic bot things, you should get the patron status, so everybody can see that you're flagged as a server player in there, and then the moderators can help you actually get on the server. I'm trying to get it automatically done, but it's proving a little bit difficult. I actually had to write an email to the Patreon platform developers earlier today to try to figure out why I'm not getting the information I need for that. Alright, so over here... Why is somebody's horse on top of a tree? Okay, never mind. yeah, there aren't any commands active at the moment. So... I don't know why he started building all of these ships or yachts, but... Spiders, yeah. There are lots of them here now. People bought yachts at the harbor, I guess you could say, at the marina, and they're just ever more bigger and more grand. It's pretty cool. Let's see if I can make it over to this one. Probably can't. Where's that? Yeah. Okay, we can do this. Okay. Couldn't make it across there. Just making my way onto somebody's yacht. Hey, friendship. And hello, Tim the Time Lord. Oh, nice. That I like this detail. That's a... steering wheel, basically. This isn't a big yacht. No, I know. There's the ones actually in the water out there too. Yeah. So there are the ones over here as well, and then this one, just like crazy. Who's this anyway? Is this... Oops. Maybe I should be in first-person view when I land. That is the worst way ever to get a shout-out, by the way. What's the tab number for? Tab number is a number of deaths or amount of negative cheat, depending on if you're Swinksy or not. But I'm assuming this yacht is Minecreep's own yacht, considering that it's the biggest. And hello to Alex, and hello to Rylon. I think you were here before, though. Can I explain why you're complaining to the new Twitch thing? Yeah, sure. Okay, so basically, from my point of view, YouTube is running ads and stuff on my videos and on my streams, right? And that gives me a bit of the money that YouTube is making. Like, it's not much, but it's a bit of the money. So basically, it's kind of a split between YouTube serving my content and me making the content, right? That's pretty fair. In my book, anyway. Now, Twitch, I appreciate that Twitch exists because YouTube has a little bit of a too strong monopoly on video and stuff. So I've been putting up all my videos and my streams on Twitch. And Twitch has partnerships, which basically is the same thing. It's the same. You do stuff, they run ads, they sell cheers and bits and all kinds of stuff, and subscriptions and all of that, and at the end of the day, it's split. Now, for whatever reason, the partnership stuff that Twitch runs is very limited. This is the shopping districts, by the way. It's a lot of pretty cool builds here. So, for whatever reason, they've limited their partnerships quite strictly. You have to be a super big channel. And now they've introduced an associates thing, which is nice, because then you can be sort of a partner without having to be a partner. Now, the problem with it is that they have also restricted that associates stuff. To be, you have to exclusively stream to Twitch. So the deal is, if I want to be an associate with Twitch and earn any money of the money that they are making off of my streams, then I have to agree to anytime I start a stream to not stream anywhere else, not to any live streams anywhere else for the coming 24 hours. So basically, if I want any part of the money that they are making from my streams, then I have to give them exclusive access to my content. So basically, because my largest audience is on YouTube, they're basically telling me, hey, go screw over all your people on YouTube. Or we're just going to have you do all the work and we're going to take all the money. That's basically it. And I'm not terribly happy about that. Because I've been trying to diversify, I've been trying to push people onto Twitch for a long time, and nice. Is there any rockets left? There's actually a few. I guess people have been buying them from the like made in China cheap knockoff place down the road. But anyway, that's why. So when they finally start actually offering like partnership or revenue sharing for people who aren't the massive Twitch channels, then they also include that restriction that I basically either stop doing all of my streams multicast, basically, which is what I've always done, or I give them all of the revenue. And I think it's bullshit, so I'm not going to have it. And it's most likely going to mean that I stop streaming to Twitch. Huh. Which is also why this is the first stream to Beam. Our fireworks are 100% guaranteed respectful of the environment and are made by hand with love. Yeah. So I don't think I've ever actually been in this part of this little section. This is very nicely built. What's this thing in my left hand? Yeah, it's a totem of undying. It makes me not die when I die. So you get them in the woodland mansions by killing the illagers there, the magician type illagers. And Miriakin village. And if you were carrying one in your hand, when you get a killing blow, so somebody or something kills you, then you don't die, you get regeneration, Oh, I thought I had more pearls. Dang. See if I can take off here with the lag on the server. It's sometimes a little bit. Yep. It makes me fly away like if I was flying, but it doesn't actually unfold the wings, which is super weird. See if I can find my sense of direction here. This is north. So be over here. I'd prefer if there was a Shulker chest of undying. Yeah, like a box that you could put stuff in and then it didn't get dropped or something. Okay, south is the complete opposite of where I need to be going. I'm also a little bit worried about the durability of my wings. But let's maybe head on back into the Nether and go by that. It's a handy portal right here. Or actually, we could fly out to Bindgrid space. It's over here. What do I think about hardened clay being called terracotta in the new snapshot? It's just another word for that. Ooh, what's this? Oh, it's somebody kept building on this? Can't seem to recall it containing this platform. Oh yeah. It's now confirmed that the Sphinx is actually not a cat, she's a villager. I'm a little bit lost. Because the view distance isn't long enough in this game to actually see my destination. I think it's this way. A box that would suck up your inventory and not despawn. Yeah, I mean, actually, I very, very much appreciate this. Like, if there was one mod that I wanted in the actual game, it would be the gravestone mod stuff. Because the, can I? Yes? Okay, it worked. This logo, it has a little bit of a creeper hole in it because somebody was standing on it and let a creeper blow up, but this the people on the server built my profile image as a pixel art. Crazy stuff. Can you die illiterate? No. So, okay. This is because of the cape. So, if you have a cape, there is... Wow, Sphinxy. Wow. If you have a cape, its patterns kind of transfer over, but not completely. So, it's like, it's not the same pattern, it's a different pattern, but it's... Yeah. It's the same theme, you could say. So this is over here is right next to Minecraft's base too. So all of this stuff over here. Hey, Evil. This is Xbox. No, this is the PC edition. So this is 1.11.2. Somebody was asking the version before. Some pretty cool stuff around here. I missed my target, by the way. I thought I was going to hit buy in space, but I flew past it somehow. Should be pretty much straight west from here. Yeah, I mean, he did say that you would be able to customize them like skins. I'm not quite sure if that was like a first idea thing and then it didn't happen or whatever, but right now it's the cape. But yeah, like what we were talking about before, like the way your items drop when you die, that's a fine mechanic, in my opinion. What I'm not so keen on is the fact that items despawn after 5 minutes, which I understand because it's like a performance thing. Why is it not loading? after your stuff drops, the way that mechanic interacts with those 5 minutes is kind of an accidental thing, right? And it depends on how your chunks are loaded and all kinds of stuff. It's not a good game mechanic because it depends on all the kinds of basically technical details about the game. Which is really... like, that's not what a game should be about. So maybe this way? So I'm trying to make my way around. There is over here. This is sort of back towards my base a little bit. Maybe this way? Oh wow, this is a completely new thing that I haven't seen. Huh. What is this even? I don't know who built here. So I'm not quite sure. But yeah, I love the mods that do a gravestone instead. I think you still get the danger of having to go back to where you were. But... oh, here we are. You don't need to worry about 5 minutes of loaded chunks and stuff like that. Please don't spam me in-game either. Can you make me a map-making tutorial for 1.11.2? There are some of my old tutorials that are going to be updated for newer versions. Map making, probably not at the moment. So this is the place where people have been lazy. This is the statue courtyard, and there are a lot of people who... so this is Sinos. He started this courtyard. But I've made mine. And a lot of people haven't made theirs. Let's get a move on, people. Is there a... yes, there's. Good. Need my ender pearls. Ooh, that one. Why do I have a diamond block? Where'd that come from? How do we get off spectator? We should probably post that link. But by the looks of things, this is the iron farm, by the way. It's pretty crazy. I started out making an iron farm, so I made one of these, like, legs. And then people went like, "Nah, we need more," and built 8 more. So now it's a 3x3 iron farm of crazy. I fail. it all ends up here. Kind of need the It's nobody's ever AFKing here, so we kind of need AFK here more to fill it up. What do I think about the new mob on 112? Oh, where? Okay. Well, map room. Actually, while we're here, because now I'm somewhere in the corridors of the old Nether Hub and not quite sure how to get it back, but the map room is a good place to go. Show that off if it's still up. Yeah. It's a pretty big map of the world. This is the spawn island. I'm not sure. It's not quite up to date, is it? But you can kind of see up here is the iron farm, the 9 towers of the iron farm. My base is sort of here. It's quite a big map. The shopping district that we were at is down this way. Around here-ish. I think. Yeah. And then some of the bases that we were visiting are like here and here and stuff. So, it's pretty big. This place. But yeah, let's try to find our way back. The IP is being posted. It's been posted a bunch of times in the stream chat. Actually, haven't posted the info in Beam chat, but we'll do that. Server. That is. Let's see. Minigames area. Oh, we haven't been there either. We should go totally go look at that. That's pretty cool. I love this banner. This banner for the minigames area is amazing. So, the new mob. The Illusioner. What? What was that message? Ooh. Some auto. Weird. Why is it doing that? I'll have to check that out. This is the minigames area. There's the game, which is a remake of A Game from a French YouTuber. And it's causing my base to be constantly filled with flower pots and all kinds of nice stuff. Illusioners. They are not done yet. So I'd rather not say too much about them, but they look pretty cool this far. This, by the way, is an interesting game. Whenever you step on any of these pressure plates, it switches from on or off the ones that are next to it. It's kind of tricky, actually. Don't you like flower pots? I don't like flower pots all over my base. this over here is the arena. This is a little bit of a problem. It's built to be able to do PvP combat in, but then it turned out that PvP is not really easily switchable per at runtime without messing a lot with teams. I think I haven't. I think I have an idea of how it could be done, but it's super complicated to be able to just switch into PvP, which is a little bit sad. Can I record this? Yeah, go ahead. I mean, I think some people have been uploading some stuff to YouTube as well from the server. There are no restrictions on the server. And there's a hedge maze here too. Which I'm not going into, because then I'm never getting out. Minecraft has officially added ninjas. I don't see why people are calling them ninjas all the time. I don't see the connection between Ninja and the new mob. Because it's very, like, it's blinding and it's shooting arrows. Which, fine, like, arrows could be a little bit like throwing stars or something, I guess. This is also supposed to be a big sort of flying arena battle place. That would be cool, but it kind of needs finishing. And then we need to figure out the PvP stuff as well. Anyway, we need to go back in the Nether. I need to go make my way over to the end and actually repair my stuff. Lots of people on who haven't been here before. but this actually is a problem now, because I don't quite know how to get to the new hub from here. I guess that would be down here. No? Oh yeah, okay. Oh! Oh, it's hidden behind my portal. Ah! Ah! Okay, now to find the end portal. Portal thing. Gateway. It should be this way, sort of just judging by directions, so it might be one of these. This is a storage. This is an ice path. Wither skeleton farm. It used to be this way, I think. This new hub is kind of it's done, but it's not entirely done, and has a banner. Okay, so let's. It's not here. Am I completely off? Industrial district. Guardian farm. Oh yeah. I'm completely off. Oh yeah, because I turned around 180 degrees. Of course. Let's see if we can make this. Let's make this work. Nope. Oh, whatever. We'll just do this. It's a little bit of a waste of food, but it's at least quick. You can also do it by boats, but it's so annoying to keep them straight. I don't quite know why people wouldn't be able to join in. I mean, I'm pretty sure we've had more people on the server than this, and it has more slots. Did I get everything legit? What do you mean legit? Like, I haven't... Like, all of the things are from survival mode. The server just runs in survival mode. And basically the only person who can switch into creative mode or anything is me. And the only reason I ever do that is to fix when something gets broken or the server is in trouble. There's no cheating going on. Well, lazy people. Destroy your boats. A little bit of lag, yeah. But how long have you been playing this server? This server started Yeah, so can I? Let's take this boat. This way is the farm over here, the XP farm. Ah! Here we go. That's better. So much better if you just have a dispenser that shoots them out and has them like lined up. We're gonna be needing to go back anyway. Okay. Let's repair. These are fine. Basically need to repair everything else. Let's do that. Okay, if you get accepted, you should get an email. Wow, that's loud. so incredibly loud. But some of the emails haven't gone out yet, so there's some people who have been accepted recently. What are you doing, Sphinxy? Still very loud. Hostile creatures. Yeah, I'm trying to get to the place where people who are, like, accepted get immediate notification and stuff. But it is not... It's not always easy. There's a lot of stuff that needs to be fixed. That is... Oh, God. So much stuff. Why am I carrying all this junk? And the site. Need to take... This is a tip, by the way, if you didn't know it. The more stuff you have with mending on it that you're holding or wearing, the slower it is to mend those things. So you actually want to take off whatever it is you're wearing that is in need of mending when you're done mending it. We're pretty close to being done. The bow needs mending as well. I don't think I have mending on a shovel. No, I don't. All right, that's good to go for a bit. Like that. Oh, turn around. And I'm sorry for the people who are sending me messages and stuff. There is no way that I can. Hello? There's no way that I can individually answer. Oh, that's what you're doing. Individually answer everything. So, if I don't individually answer your question specifically, then I'm sorry. Is there a Patreon server or can anybody join? So, it is a Patreon server, kind of. But there's also a random draw. So, if you want to play on it, you can enter your name on a forum on my website. That's been linked a bunch of times in chat. And I missed. But if you want to be guaranteed to join, then you can sign up to Patreon as well. That boat thing is pretty common. Possibly not the fastest way anymore, but one of the fastest way to move around. And this is annoying. Who broke this stuff? Alright. I never actually showed you the inside of my base. I just realized this place has been a mess for so long, and just recently I fixed this up. Why is there a shulker box here? So this is the output of the mob farm. These boxes up here, so there's actually quite a bit of stuff in here. Some of them not so much, because I've been taking all the redstone out and stuff, but there's quite a lot of stuff, and the storage is actually reasonably sorted now. Do I have a girlfriend? Yes, I do. And there's still some stuff left to do here, but for the most part, this is getting there. And then we can actually take a ride here and go down here. This is Sphinxy built up this entire tunnel. It's pretty nice. It used to be kind of ugly, but now we can't access the sides here. This leads into our lighthouse project, which is a never-ending source of work. There's a little bit of a redstone circuit in here. I have asked you to not spam me with PMs either. And I've told you that I will not be able to answer every question, so I'm sorry. This little circuit over here is a little clock running, and it's moving the lighthouse around. And if we go down here, this is like the one really big project that I'm taking on the server. There's tons of redstone wiring going to a bunch of lamps and stuff. Some of them are not hooked up yet. And then this is the bottom of the ocean that has been replaced by wool. So, there's that. Who do you host the server with? The server is hosted on Apex. It would be good if I could find my way back in. There we go. Let's see if we can make it out here too. So a little cheaty entrance. So in the end, you get lamps spinning around up there. And then on the bottom of the ocean, you can actually see, as the lamps light up, you can see it light up the environment, which is pretty cool. Let's go over there maybe and see if we can see it. So I guess the light's on the opposite side by now. This thing keeps breaking, by the way. As does this door. And oops. Oh, come on. This master key is what you need to get into the base. So this is like a little lock thing that I built because people are continuously going into my base and wrecking all of everything. A liver log. That's a new thing. Alright, here we are. The lights up there are spinning around, and then down here you'll also see... Oops. Yeah, there. The bottom of the ocean lights up as this spins around. This is pretty cool. It's not as spectacular effect as you kind of want, but... I'm not going to advertise it, but here's the advertisement. People. Alright, anyway. Set on in there. We're a little bit over all over the place today. We're just, since basically I'm just showing people around the server. So, let's see. We are here. We have been... nice, I didn't even see the painting. We've not been here. So there's a bunch of places I haven't even been to in the server. Ooh, fancy. Where's my food? How can I spectate? Just connect to the server. If you're not a server player, then you'll end up in spectator mode. Why are you streaming? You should be working on 1.12. Well, actually, I should be working on like 1.1 or something in that case, because I don't... I mostly, let's say, don't work on the Java edition. A liter drop? Ground level? Sure. We'll do the drop. Okay. Ooh, there's speed here. Ooh. Oh, wow. Okay. This is a little bit bigger than I expected. What's this? Enjoy the view of Jacktopia Kingdom. Nice. Holy crap, this is... this is quite big! And a mesa too, that's nice. Oh, and even more over there. Oh wow, the big shield. Nice. Let's get down here, maybe. Walk the streets of this town. I haven't actually. Maybe the market square is a good place to land? I haven't actually been here before. This is just pretty cool to walk around. I hope that worked. There are the details in a Beam chat as well if you want to find out how to apply for the server or and the server IP is on that page as well. Holy crap, this is epic. I'd never seen this before. House of vending machines. Just huh. There's actually more to this. Hello. Every house, yeah. That's this has got to taken quite some time. This is really nice. So I really like the fact that there's like a clear style to the entire thing. But then there's also some like individual styles in the houses and stuff. Oh, this is awesome. I know he built it. It's his space. I just haven't been here before, that's all. Ooh, ah! That's the danger with the long burn fireworks. Almost ran into things. Yeah, this is pretty cool. I like this place. So where have we not been? Mean, I think at all of the places over on my side of the server, mine and Sphinxy Space, the shopping district. We've been at the. Ooh, what's that? We've been at the Iron Farm and the mini game area. I lost. Oh, here. Lost track of things. And we've been to Bine and Minecreep side. I guess we haven't, we haven't been in Tucson's base. I need to go up here. If you haven't seen, I was actually there earlier in the stream, JK. We're talking about the outside being done, but not the inside. It's a pretty big build. Okay, where are we? 2,000 out and 1,000 out. It's quite far from spawn. I like the oops, like the shield. I think the portal was up there that we came through, so we might as well go back there. Yeah, it was. I'm waiting on concrete to the inside. Yeah, I'm a little bit bummed out that I managed to do. Let's see, this should be actually. Nope. Ah, come on. Nope. Okay, I guess we're just running then. I'm a little bit bummed out that I managed to do so much of the underwater reef thing that I did before concrete was announced. Because that would have been awesome for concrete, but it'll be good with the new wool colors too, so I'll just leave it, I think. Nope. Okay, never mind. I'm just gonna waste fireworks that way. This will be awesome when, this tunnel is extended all the way. You don't like the palette? I think it's pretty good. All the same color. I'm not quite sure what you mean with that. So we've been here. We've been at Bynes. We've been in the industrial district. Courtyard we've been in. Made a map in 1.12 snapshot, and in the next snapshot everything broke. That's what snapshots are about, and that's also why I generally don't do much map making work on snapshots. Sphinx, you should probably make some form of command, like a plugin-driven command for, we've been there, been in Minecraft space, Mesa biome. It's not very interesting because it's just a basically place to mine clay. Guardian farm, it's just a farm. Been at the end. Been there. See. So we haven't been at Tucson's base. Let's go there. It's pretty cool. Haven't been at Beef space either. I don't know if she's done anything lately. No, if she's on the server much anymore, but it's still a pretty awesome place. There are 15 people on Beam, twice as many on YouTube, and 3 times less than that on Twitch. Yeah, there's 4 on Twitch right now, and I think I can't count as one. This is pretty cool. This is too, since it does look like the tree is a little bit broken, but basically this is the Shire. So there's like all these little nice round doors. Tucson Benson's respectable home. And you can go in. It feels a little bit cramped and hobbity in here. It's pretty cool. I haven't been here in ages either. Guess she must have been on since she just made the banner and all. There's some interesting stuff in the space. Iron Man suit. Another working clothing. Norwegian sexy laundry. Fashionable beachwear. It's like nothing. I need a banner. the signs. Actually, there's some pretty good banner making sites and banner list sites and stuff where people upload good banners. Just go look there and like experiment with changing some. That's, I think, how I made the last ones I had. Did I see your Discord message? When are we? This is not the portal I entered through. When are you talking about that? Oh, wait, about the map? Arena? Where am I? Oh, okay. Fine, we came out of another one, but that's fine. yes, I did see that. I'm sorry, I didn't have time to answer and then I forgot about answering. Oh, I see where all the iron from the iron farm went. wow. Ooh. I'll get back to you on that, Misa. Well, the short of it is, I think it will be maybe perhaps a little more work than we'll have time for this version. Mine the lava or not. Wow. This iron. This is a crazy amount of iron. And ugly was here. Wow. This goes up for a bit. So sorry also if I've been missing messages in chat. I am not used to doing three chats at once. Two chats at once is quite sufficient to mess up your head sometimes. So all of that was deep underground, and we're basically at spawn. Oh, this. Oh! Huh. Interesting. I did not know that. Yeah, there's actually four chats, that's right, because there's the in-game chat as well. It is not easy to keep in mind, and I'm not looking at Discord, by the way, because I don't need a fifth chat to keep track of. How long am I streaming? Probably not that long today. I've been streaming for an hour now, so maybe like half an hour. I just wanted to do like a tour through the server and look at all the things, and we basically looked at most of the things by now. So there's a I don't have a five screen desk. I have three. That's quite enough, and it doesn't help. It's main streaming setup is a little bit crazy. So on my main screen, I have Minecraft now, and I have three chat windows. And then on my big off screen, I have OBS, and I have all the three different streams with all of their stats. And I have my multicast window and Discord. All of those windows on one screen. And then on my left off screen, I have my web browser and Twitter and stuff. So it's a little bit crazy. I realize we never went into the actual castle. So maybe we should go. Oh, I see this little place. Oh, never knew that was the entrance to that big underground base. Let's go over to spawn and walk the bridge over, because that's a nice way to enter. Is that underground now? No, it's here. There we go. All of the chats, yes. Just found a huge cactus farm. Yeah, we have a couple of those. So this is kind of how you get to the castle. And there's lots of space, different space inside of this place. Haven't been here for a while either. And all people have rooms in here. Let's see if we go down. There's a bunch of empty space here. I don't know if you can still access like the underside. There was a massive hole under this place where you basically could see down to bedrock. You're playing with fire today, Sphinxy. Can I see spectators? No. Okay, that leads outside. Interesting. Oh, okay. We're climbing. Or actually, this might be it. No, this is the other side of that little inner garden place. That's nice. This place is absolutely humongous, and they built it in like a couple of days. It's crazy. Who? Little bit of a tight space. Oh, here's way up. What server is that? Okay, so this is... Okay. This is an interesting tower. Oh, no! God dang it. Elytra and ladders. Loads of command blocks. Yeah, those are the ones that control the systems for people joining in and stuff. There's also a sleeping system and some other old stuff that's been disabled. Ah, it's a bit of still sad that you can't really... You can look out, but you can't, like, see properly from here. Oh well. So this is my fan server, for those who have joined in. It's a server we've been running for... 1.5 years? Something like that? And if you want to join in, you can join in and be... Like, so there's a bunch of people on here right now that are at the bottom of the list there that are italic name. And those are people who are in spectator mode. So if you join in, of course, there's going to be place for more yachts. If you join in, you get set into spectator mode. And if you want to play in survival, you can either apply on a list on a form of on my website. It's been posted in chats a couple of times. And hello. Oh, that's one way to do it. Or you can become a patron on Patreon. Here we are. This is what I was talking about. Is there actually no like proper way in or out anymore? But yeah, those from the list on my website are random draws, and we usually do them at the end of streams. So, and there's, let me just warn you, straight up front, it's quite a long list by now. So, the chances are pretty slim on each drawing, but your name stays on the list, so. I don't know, something with this floor, just, I love the looks of this floor. It's just something about how it looks is just really nice. It's just, is it black? Yeah, black stained glass on top of it. And this whole thing. I think actually the purpose of the building this... What? Actually, the purpose of building this was basically to have farms. Can the next stream be today? Ah, no. Is there any easy way up? Or to a portal? Whatever. Let's see. Lots of storage. Okay, never mind. Is there... Oh yeah, here. This will do. Unlimited time. Oh. Oh, come on. Oh, well, this works, actually. Enjoy your blue name, by the way. Oh, come on, is there no... There's no way up? Are you kidding me? You guys don't know how to build an island. Ah! Oh, here. A loophole. There we go. Alright, Sino, where is your base? My chat and your chat are offset, by the way. Will there ever be a server reset? There's no plans for one right now, at least. A lot of people are like saying that they want a server reset because there's nothing left to build, but sector 2 end of the hub and to the right. Okay. Let's just go over here then. So there's a lot of people who are like, ah, we want to reset because there's nothing left to build. But then they build everything again in like 1 week and then they want to reset again. So like, I don't really see server resets as a good way to keep a server going. Where are we? We're one. This way. Uh-huh. I really like this banner system of finding your way. Makes it so much easier to find people's bases. Whoa. Here or here? I'm taking a chance on this one. Is there anywhere I can fly off from? It's always nice to get like an aerial view. Nice. It looks like it's like a part of a castle or something, but then it's just a wall. Oh, it's a little bit too far away to see properly. That's sad. I've never needed... Woo! Okay, I have jump boost. Be careful. I've never needed a world reset. Any server I've played on, because there's always... You can always make huge projects in Minecraft, and if you just think a little bit, you can come up with something really cool to make, and that takes really long. And the bad part is the other people who aren't playing as much, including me, because I don't... Honestly, it's my fan server, but I also don't have time to play on it every day, because then I wouldn't have time to record videos. So, I don't play as much as some of the other people on here. Which also means that I basically wouldn't, you know, all of the stuff that I'm building would never get finished and then we reset. So, it's always a little problem like that. Reset once or twice every year like Hermitcraft. Yeah, I think they are in a little bit of a different situation, to be honest. And I don't mind it for... Slice Lime for Hermitcraft Season 6. Yeah, I mean, you convince Izuma. But they have, you know, a bunch of YouTubers on the server, and they all play lots, because they all record on there. So, where was the portal that I came out of? There. So, because they do that, they have much more of an incentive to reset and restart and stuff. I'm inside you. So dirty. You also haven't been to Beef Space. Nice. This is a very nice touch. I like those. You have a bit of storage. Ooh. Oh, is this like a... Does this work? Ooh, nice! I'm impressed. It's usually hard to get those kind of things to work properly in multiplayer. Oh, I see. You see, that's where that was. I didn't even see the... I didn't see that there was an entrance. Farms. So yeah, I mean, it's obviously a little bit different if you're... What? If you're running like a YouTube... Oh. Oh, I see. If you're running a YouTube channel and you want content, then seasons makes a lot more sense. Have I done the UHC yet? That's a sad story. So the UHC that was supposed to be done, the charity UHC with Evotech, was during the Easter weekend. And what I did during the Easter weekend, instead of doing that, was become food poisoned and feeling terrible. Keep inventories off. So I actually couldn't join. Which sucked. I really looked forward to that. I love that kind of events. But what can you do? What can you do? Bulk sugarcane. Yeah. I have my farm too. Suddenly became a lot more useful when the firework thing started happening. Shouldn't have eaten rotten flesh. I don't know. It was actually, I think, rotten candy. Because of Easter, we bought candy the day before. And then I started feeling really nauseous in the evening. And then, like, the day after, I was like, my stomach was completely not feeling happy. Oh, wrong way, I think. And then I had a fever and stuff all day. It was not fun. Let's just say that. And I'm lost. Huh? Huh? Are there missing banners, or did I just not... Can I just not read? That is a very fancy banner. I like that one. I get so heartbroken when servers reset, both for playing and watching. I think there is a thing for big servers that's been running for a long, long time. Like, they just become such a much bigger thing. Like, there's so impressive builds and stuff on it, and it's kind of sad to see that disappear. So there are some of these that aren't hooked up with banners and stuff. See a creeper. Thanks for joining in. Courtyard doesn't have banners. We need to fix that. I honestly don't even know where that is anymore. I've lost track. It should be pretty close to Tucson's, I guess. This is sort of over in the same general direction. And here's just an unmarked tunnel. Ryland's base. Shopping district. Ryland's, we were there. All the A. There's a bunch of people who have tunnels here and stuff. Here's Speedfix. That aren't, like, playing much on the server, too? Is this the one? Where do I end up if I go here? It's just me and you now, chicken. Oh, so this is the portal. Okay. This is here. This is not where I wanted to go. And that's the wrong direction. I think, I guess, we're going over here. This is what happens when you rebuild another hub. You get, like, before you've actually rebuilt everything, you just get everything is a little bit broken. Alright, here we go. Now we're inside a BFX place, which is this is a pretty nice little place that you end up with, and you can actually see out through this glass ceiling there, because all of this stuff is like in a really cool location. And I'm out of food. And he has this really nice little inner courtyard with a wall and stuff. So this place is pretty cool. I just when I was making that fan server flyover, that it's a super long render. I was looking for ways to include everything, and I couldn't get this place in because it's so indoors and stuff. And that render does indoors really poorly. Oh, hey, Tucson, I didn't even see you join in there. But it's a little bit of a pity because it's a really nice place. This, and if you fly over, ooh, I'm gonna touch. Yep, he has this little archway of here, and you can actually see down there. It's pretty cool, and then we can fly over here too. Oh, no. And over here, we're back at the shopping district. So that is pretty cool. I'm going to see if I can... Let's just land here at my rocket shop. That's a pretty nice... Is this a door? Huh. I haven't seen this. Now I wonder if I'll ever get back out. Dad! You fail. Okay, so it's a switch. It's a toggle switch. But what is it for? Oh, I see. Oh, it's like a general trading store. Huh. Ah, that's cool. So, I'm gonna start running off the stream. So I'm just gonna park myself in my shop for a little bit. And I'm gonna switch over to stuff that's off screen that you can't see. And download the server application form list thing. The thing of things, if I can figure out how to do this. Because I only do it like once every stream, so of course I don't remember exactly how to do it. Download responses, there we go. Save that, open that. Okay, sort that, fix that, do the things. Delete columns, sort all the things. Sort by nickname. Alright, so currently there are 429 entries to this list. However, there's not 429 names. It's because a bunch of people have signed up like 8 times or whatever. And a bunch of people have already been drawn. So it's not as bad as it sounds. But we're going to do a random draw. Oops. One and... What did I just say? 400 and something? 429. And then we're going to see. Burn his shop. What is this sabotage? This is a legitimate business. What's my favorite build on the server? I think it's better if I don't say anything. incite the biggest competition of all times or something. First number is 363 on the list. And by the way, if I select something that's a duplicate, we're gonna reroll. So just signing up once is good enough. At Sphinxy. I think she's already on the server. So we can reroll that one. Why are you on the list, Sphinxy? You've been on the server since before there was a list. Okay. Blintleton. It's a joke application. Well, it has as much of a chance as anybody else to be picked. So, you know, it's gonna be picked eventually. All right, let's draw another number. I need to make some better way of doing this. Number 13. Somebody's already on the server. 267. Near 1325. That wasn't 67, that was 267. Alright, 407. Whoops. Were you just making everybody a mod now? Is that what's going on? 407 is Voss 3464. Isn't he already on the server or switched names or something? How can I even check that? This makes me want more friends. Fine, whatever. I'll stop doing that. That's a nice view out the window. I can't remember. I recognize his name. I think he's on the server already, but we'll just set his name. Enjoy the ride, by the way. Stream viewers, 362. Swifter is already on the server. Is he not? No, he isn't. Huh? Or? Rose? No. I am just being an idiot. Come on. Get my focus on the right window. This was just a little bit annoying. Two, four, three is okay. Thanks. Wow. Two diamonds per stack of something. What are we buying in this place? Oh. Vols is already a member. Yeah, that's what I thought. It's a flower and a dye shop. Nice. We're just going to stand over here for a bit. Because that was... it was a little bit annoying. And we're going to draw one more name because we picked one who is already a member. And that is 226. Scroll, 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 scroll. 226. Scroll even more. 226 is there. I'll just flee the noise, the horror. Flee into the distance. The what now? What's this place? No, we were doing a... That was basically the same instant. Alright. We were doing a server tour. I ended up somewhere I have never seen before, but that's fine. Mine... Creature. And it's funny that some of these people are the people who have been around for a long time who goes like, ooh, I like your stuff, please, and then they just come on and do that. And it's like... That's not going to help your position. Anyway, people have mods because Sphinxy has been generous in handing out the mod or operator group memberships today. We'll all have our harsh, less funny party in a while when we strip everybody of their privilege. Anyway, I'm going to head out. I need to get some food. A little bit of a shorter stream today, but that's it. Anyway, and I just wanted a nice time to sort of go around the server and show everybody everything. And just to repeat once more time, if you're on Twitch, which is not many people now, but if you're watching on Twitch, make sure you sign up, follow me on Beam as well, or subscribe on YouTube, because at some point, I don't know exactly when, but at some point I'll very likely stop streaming to Twitch. But that's it for this time. Thanks for watching, and catch you laters.